Good afternoon. This is the third part of our big test. Today we will look at the work in SDR Full HD and upscale to 4K. So, let's see one more image from test set 007. This is a frame with vegetables. It is good, because there is a lot of color, a lot of color transitions, a lot of details, and here to a greater extent the nuances of color interpolation are shown. Let's look at the graphics first. I will only tell you about the differences. First, as in the previous test, in both Fire TV displays a big difference between the mode of output 422 12-bit and 444 with 8 or 10-bit. You can see that the graphs show a higher quality image in 444 mode. Looking at the vectorscope and the brightness channel histogram, you can see that it has small spikes in the 422 mode. Shield TV has the same effect. 444 8-bit mode is more preferable for SDR output. Again, note the spikes on the brightness channel. Only they are much more noticeable than the Fire TV. Apple TV as before, shifts the colors towards the green channel. And here is how Xiaomi looks like. According to the graphs, it is not much different from the others, except for less saturation in colors, probably because of the additional processing. The other players react to output changes with slightly different color saturation. And this is due to color interpolation. Because when you output 444, there are more conversions, because 422 is recorded in the file. It turns out that there is almost no difference as such between different players. Now look at the screenshots themselves. I will just switch between them. The biggest difference you'll be able to see on this straw-cut vegetable. Just because you'll see a difference, it's actually a difference in the principle and the color interpolation algorithm. It doesn't say that someone is doing it right and someone isn't. It's just different algorithms. See the difference on the edges of the straw, and, horizontally and vertically, there will be different differences. This is the original. This is Oppo in 422 mode. This is Oppo in 444 mode. See the difference? There is a red shift, horizontally. It seems to come alive and move, but these are just different output modes. From this picture, it is very easy to understand what mode the output is in. For example, it is clearly seen that Apple TV outputs in 444 mode. You see what a sharp shift goes horizontally, relative to Oppo in 422 mode, the same as for Oppo 444, but if we compare the Oppo in 444 mode and Apple TV, we see that there is a slight difference in the left edge. But it is because of the different way of color interpolation. The same sharp shift in Dune Real Vision, because again the output is in 444. But again, compare with Oppo with the same 444, we see that Dune also has a different vertical shift. But all because of a different direction of interpolation. The others all look about the same. The difference is either because of the different output or the different interpolation algorithm. Let's look at the Xiaomi. The vegetables look clearer. You can see it even in 100% image. There are so much strong contrast transitions in the original picture. Rather, it can be called not sharpness, but micro contrast. Notice the difference is only in the red channel. I have already explained in my first video. If you are interested in theory, watch this video, contains a lot of useful theoretical information. And now let's look at the outsider of this test. It was Fire TV Stick 4K Max. Yes, the new version of the stick has not in the first test already has worse quality, even comparing to its predecessor. It clearly has a defect in processing SDR 1080p. In fact, he outputs color vertically without converting it to 1080p C. You can see the teeth. It has not fully interpolated the color in the image. Horizontally it is restored. But vertically it is forgotten. And it is both in 422 output mode and in 444 output mode. I purposely repeated the capture several times. But it is not an error. It is the only one who allowed such a defect. why is it bad? Let's just say it is visible. If you watch it on TV, of course it will be visible only on high-quality clear movies, where there is a lot of red color. But in fact it should not be, it's a bug. Now, let me show you again, and prove that all the difference between the players is nothing more than the difference in color interpolation from the original 420. There is no difference in clarity or detail, except for the Xiaomi. Look, we leave the brightness channel. I'll show you Fire TV Max first. So you can see that it's not the clarity that's the problem, it's the color restoration. Look. Here it is a color picture, and we see the stripes are defective. Leaving only the brightness channel, the stripes disappeared. Let's compare the image with Fire TV Max in 444 mode. Remember there was a displacement of red straw, now everything is the same. Let's compare it with other players, for example Oppo. Identical. There is no difference at all which output is 422 or 444, now it makes no difference. Neither does the principle of color interpolation. Because there is no color. In fact, the only difference we see is the Apple TV, less brightness, and the Xiaomi, clearer picture. Once again, I repeat that all players output identical picture sharpness if the original image was recorded, not in 420, but in 444. There would be no difference even in color image. About Xiaomi. Let's speculate a little. And whether it is well seen greater clarity. I answer, in a direct comparison on a 77-inch OLED TV from a distance of 2 meters, there is a difference even on regular movies. It is small, but there is, it is difficult to describe, but as if the eyes began to see better. Does it give a more beautiful and pleasing to the eye? The answer is complicated. The image becomes more detailed. Plus the TV, when upscaling to 4K does extra conversion with it. If you ask me, if you need that clarity to watch movies, I'll answer this. I think this player is the perfect choice for owners of full HD TVs, especially cheap ones where the built-in processor doesn't know how to process video properly. For owners of TV with 4K and full HD TV with excellent processing, this player rather creates excessive clarity. No, it's not conspicuous, but not always emphasized. A little detail is useful. The fact is that it can create excessive flow of information, which in a particular movie can be superfluous, create a wrong perception, change the artistic intent. So when I was comparing myself, Xiaomi, with other players on the same piece of film, I saw this more detailed picture. And I will not say that I liked it. Of course it's a matter of habit and direct comparison. Maybe if we watch only with Xiaomi, our eyes will adapt, and we will stop seeing that the image is a bit different. So for now my verdict is, for owners of full HD TV I think this is a great player. But let's not get too far ahead of the curve, there are still many more tests to come. Let's move on to the upscale test with number 026. This is a familiar frame from my previous tests. Here the original frame itself is very clear and detailed, and there are different kinds of elements, which are good to look for differences between the players in processing and upscaling. In particular we will pay attention to the text processing, to the wire processing. This time we will switch to the brightness channel, because it is responsible for clarity and detail, so we won't get in the way of color. Let me start by showing you how Dune Real Vision works. Actually it still uses an increased level of sharp filter for upscaling. So its image seems to be very clear. But fine details are eaten away, and the image becomes plastic, unnatural. Next, Fire TV Stick 4K old version. He has everything just fine. Upscale is excellent. Detail, and at the same time there is no lost details or super contrast. But new Fire TV Max once again shows its inconsistency in SDR processing. Let's see. At first glance it looks good, but the devil is in the details. Look closely to the image, look at the letters, look at the black border of the umbrella. You see. Again a glitch that we have already seen in the test with vegetables. The image is not smooth. But if you look even more closely, we see an even sadder thing. Let's zoom into 200% so we can see better. Look at the wire and compare it to what its predecessor produced. As they say, the difference is very noticeable, but that's not all. Look at the thin vertical lines, semi-transparent. These are some ghost lines that come from some unknown place. Here on the umbrella you can see all the defects that this player has. Next, Xiaomi. Here everything is simple, in terms of the quality of details, everything is perfect, all the letters are worked out, the umbrella and the black border are perfectly brought out, the wires are also perfect. The only thing lacking a bit is clarity. Amlogic got rid of the defects of the previous version, where there were small defects in details, but the overall clarity is a bit lower than the leaders. But as I have already shown in the video about upscaling, it is very easy to make a clearer image from a good quality one. Note, the upscaling algorithm no longer works here, as it did in the 1080p output. Next is OnTV and X2 Cube. As before, they are a little short of the leaders in clarity. But this is not a problem, as I said before. Next is the Oppo. Here you can say that its processing is weak, not only is the clarity worse than the leaders, and even worse than Amlogic, but there is also a problem with the visibility of horizontal stripes. Look at the letters, look at the umbrella and fringe, and look at the wires. All in all, there is a failure here for Oppo. Next, the Shield TV in enhanced upscale mode and the Apple TV. They are completely equal in clarity and detail, and there are no differences at all, except for a glitch of less brightness on the Apple TV. AI mode for Shield TV I have not included here in the test. If interested, see the video about upscale. It turns out that the leaders in visible clarity are the old Fire TV Stick, Apple TV and Shield TV. Dune Real Vision, like clear, but plasticine is visible to the amateur in general, who likes over-sharpness. Xiaomi stands apart. It has better object processing. No jagged edges on wires or diagonal lines. But compared to the leaders, a little less sharpness. But once again, this is not a problem. And the worst is definitely Fire TV 4K Max. It is likely that working with SDR when developing the new chip was in last place. Another fact, if you compare how the algorithms work, you can see that the image is shifted when moving between frames. The upscale algorithm makes a new image slightly shifting the original frame. And actually there are three groups here. The first group is Dune. The second group is Shield TV and Apple, and the third group, everyone else. And let's look at the graphs at the end, what they can tell us additionally. The first, the picture, is an upscale made by DaVinci Resolve itself. Next, Dune Real Vision. You can see how it tried to maximize the contrast, while forgetting that the hues on the highlights will suffer from this, they are just gone now. Pay attention to the vectorscope. You can see that the white spot in the center has become larger. This is the consequence of this overestimation of contrast. About the same does the new Fire TV Max. It also slightly overestimates the contrast, and look at Parade. Compared to the old stick, you can see how the graph is stretched. Next up is the Xiaomi. The difference with the old Fire TV, for example, in a bit less saturation. This is incidentally observed with all Amlogic. Amlogic does not try to stretch the contrast and colors as much as possible. From what catches the eye, it is a problem with the Shield TV in the brightness channel, as we found out it is a consequence of the output in 422 mode. And plus, if you look closely in this mode, Shield TV also changes the color balance a bit. The blue channel at the top goes down a bit. Well, the problem with Apple TV, the shift towards the green channel. Well, that's the end of the SDR tests. Let's summarize a little intermediate results. Apple TV requires calibration of the TV, because it shifts the color balance, so it cannot be considered a quality source, with interlacing bad, upscale one of the best. Dune Real Vision, the colors are fine, let down by its problems with interlacing and upscaling. Fire TV Stick 4K Old Version, very good, colors are fine, de-interlace is not bad, after Oppo and Shield, I put it in third place, upscale in the leaders. Fire TV Stick Max is sad here. There are problems with color interpolation, there are problems with interlacing, there are problems with upscaling. In my opinion so far it is in the outsiders. Xiaomi Mi TV Stick 4K, de-interlace is weak, color and clarity in 1080p is great, best in terms of detail in 1080p, upscale if not considering a little less clarity, best in quality. On TV, held up well overall, in terms of color and clarity in 1080p good, slightly understated in terms of brightness levels, but this can only be seen from the charts, de-interlace is average, upscale good, but slightly lacking in clarity compared to the leaders. The Oppo, except for the upscale, held up fine everywhere, interlace handling the best of all. Colors are reference, but upscale is not its strong suit. Shield TV, I like the de-interlacing quite well, I yield it only to Oppo, I need to tune up the colors, it is optimal to output in 4448-bit mode, upscale is in the LED. X2 Cube, de-interlace not bad, Corelec is good friends with VC1, colors like everyone else, normal, clarity in Corelec excellent, in Android there is a problem. Upscale good, but conceded the leaders a bit. Maybe a little later I'll make another video with the analysis of the capture in 444 mode on the Magewell card, try to see what will be interesting there. Exactly to capture without lowering the color channel horizontally. That's about it. The next video will be a test in HDR mode. I hope it was interesting, subscribe, like and comment. Thank you all. Goodbye, everyone.